one, you said that you feel that you cannot afford to just stand by and be a spectator in the presidential race given the circumstances. I wanted to ask you, what do you think is the risk to Singapore if a person were to be elected who lacks, you know, the qualities you outlined, experience and a steady hand?
The presidency is a very important office in Singapore. The duties of the presidency are spelled out in the constitution. The president has custodial duties. He can exercise executive responsibilities within limited areas and on the advice of the cabinet. Difficult decisions lie ahead for Singapore. I believe that you need a president who is experienced, who is steady, who has worked in government, who has knowledge of the international system, who knows the conditions both nationally and internationally in order to come to wise decisions. So it is very important for Singaporeans to take all these into account when they cast their votes in the presidential elections. Yes.
Do you think you have the temperament to be president? And also, if you were to be elected, are there any particular areas or groups of Singaporeans that you like to focus on or to be known for? And also, now that you will be resigning from GIC as well as SPH, have preparations begun or do you have any idea of who will be taking over your position?
Well, so the first question as to whether I have the temperament to for the presidency, I think that's a matter for Singaporeans to judge rather than for me to say. But obviously, I would not have put myself forward. You know, I did not think that I had the capability and right frame of mind to execute the duties of the presidency. With regard to particular groups of people in Singapore, the president has to look after all Singaporeans. But I've been very much involved in charitable work over the years in my various capacities and as patron of various charitable groups and social welfare groups. Singapore today is an advanced country. Our standard of living is high. Most Singaporeans are living well, but there are groups of Singaporeans who are disadvantaged and who need help. And one of the areas which I would like to concentrate on if I'm elected the president is to see what I can do to help Singaporeans who are disadvantaged, who are handicapped, who need assistance. Who may have fallen between the cracks, and to see how we can rally Singaporeans and society in order to help alleviate some of their needs. There was one last point.
Who will be taking over your positions in GIC and SPH?
Well, GIC has a statement if you
that one, yes,
send that to the GIC PR.
Yeah. I think statements will be made by both organizations. In your course. Sorry?
Good time. Take from today again. Can you just talk a bit about GIC's, your role in GIC and if elected, you're going to be president of Singapore. It seems like, you know, the president of Singapore is to safeguard the reserves, while at GIC you have a view to investing for the future. How do you see these two roles? Do you see any synergy in them? Do you see it, how do you reconcile these two roles that you might take?
Well, after I've resigned from GIC as effective the 1st of July, the management of the reserves by GIC is the responsibility of the GIC management. The president has custodial duties to ensure that the reserves are properly managed. In my current position at GIC, I know that the president has full knowledge of what the what GIC does, what is the state of the reserves. And I think that if I'm elected the president, I will fulfill these duties. It may perhaps be an advantage that having worked in GIC as deputy chairman and executive director on a full-time basis the last 6 years, and actually having been a director of GIC since it was established in 1981, I probably know as much about the management of the reserves as anyone in Singapore, and I think that this could be an advantage in the president exercising his custodial responsibilities with regard to looking after the reserves. Yes.
Young CN online citizen, as you have resigned from SPH and GIC, how much money have you lost in terms of average remuneration a year by sacrificing and taking this step to stand as president?
Let me just say that I've always regarded service in government and in the public sector as an honor and a privilege, not as a career move or to be measured in terms of how much money you may make or you may lose. There is a salaries review committee now, which has been set up under the chairmanship of Mr. Gerardi, who is reviewing salaries of political office holders, including the president. I believe that I'm confident that they will come to a wise decision, and I will accept that decision. Right.
Elgin from the Straits Times. The last presidential election campaign that we had in 1993 was a fairly muted affair. There were no political rallies and very limited campaigning. Have you drawn up plans for your own campaign? Are you going to be holding rallies? And can you tell us other things about your campaign strategy or plans?
Well, I think the details of the campaign will be revealed in due course, but I will just say in general, I think as Deputy Prime Minister Teo Chien has said, the campaign for the presidency has to be different from the campaign for the members of parliament. I mean, it has to be, in my view, to be a dignified affair. We should not let the campaign become personal. I would hope that in this presidential contest, that it will be conducted in accordance with the dignity of the office of the presidency.
From Peter Harian. Now that you are out from the PAP and may soon become the president, unifier of the people, what are some of the immediate, some of the public policies that you immediately review for the benefit of people at large?
I think that the government is presently reviewing all the policies, and I believe that it is not the responsibility of the president to try and suggest changes in policy. That is a job of the government, not of the president. Obviously, the president will have his own views, and if the government of the day feels that the views may be helpful, then of course the president will be free to offer his views. But I want to stress again, there is only one power center in Singapore, and that is the government of the day. The presidency is not a second power center in Singapore and should not be a second power center to rival the government. Otherwise, there will be chaos. And it is up to the government to see how the policies can be executed, what policies are needed because they have to go to the people every 5 years in order to renew their mandate. I believe the present government is doing this, as you can see, very rigorously and in a very energetic way. Yes, there's a few last questions.
What are your views, Joshua, from the online citizen? What are your views that the elected president ultimately does not have the power to decide on presidential pardons?
Sorry?
What are your views that the elected president does ultimately doesn't have the power to decide on presidential pardons?
Presidential pardons?
Yes, for death penalty cases.
Oh, I see. It is spelled out quite clearly in the constitution that in the, for example, in the issues like the granting of pardons or commuting of sentences, the president has to act on the advice of the cabinet. Each time this arises, it is an enormous complex responsibility. So I think that is why I believe that the president has to be compassionate, deliberate, and thorough by nature before he can make a wise decision on each of these difficult issues.
Any last questions? Lydia?
One last one, perhaps.
Many of your views are consistent, in line with views expressed by the government, including DPM, TO. That might lead to some scepticism that among some Singaporeans that you are not like a government-backed candidate. I'd like to ask you, how you think that might affect your chances at the polls?
I must say what I believe, and I must say what I think is good for Singapore. It happens to coincide with some of the views expressed by ministers. It's up to the people of Singapore to judge, but I don't think there is a job of the presidential candidate to express contradictory views for the sake of just being different. I don't think that is likely to advance the future of Singapore and Singaporeans. First of all, I'd like to make it very clear in response to the last question that I am running as an independent candidate in this election without seeking the backing of any political party. I know that this will be a difficult election. I'm taking a risk, but I believe that I have a responsibility to step forward and to contest the elections in the light of the complex challenges which Singapore faces today. And going ahead is a difficult world. The president will have to make significant decisions which will require a steady hand, experience, the ability to work with the government, all political parties, and also to represent the country internationally, which is a very important responsibility of the president, as well as to look after the future of Singaporeans here at home. And finally, let me say that I believe that the president must be above politics. He must work with the government, he must work with all political parties, he must work with all civil service or civil society groups, do his part to heal divisions in our society, whether these divisions be political divisions or economic decisions, divisions. Thank you very much.